All right. Thanks, everybody. I'm really excited to be talking here today. My name is Jake Wasserman. I'm a software engineer at Facebook, and I'll be talking about a project we call the Daylight Map Distribution. So our goal at Facebook, we have chosen OpenStreetMap to serve to the Maps product surfaces and essentially all Facebook products. And so our goal is to serve OSM safely to those users. And what essentially I mean by that is that we need an OSM Planet dataset with no harmful edits. And I intentionally put this word issues here in scare quotes. We need to minimize the number of these issues, things like vandalism and graffiti, maybe some not quite intentional things like multi-polygon relation geometry errors. We need to make sure the road network is consistent, things like coastlines. There's tons of other checks that we are putting into the system. I don't have a lot of time to talk about all of them. But the main thing, another constraint that we had is that we want to serve 100% OpenStreetMap data. And what I mean by that is that there are no forks. So if we find any issues or anything on the map, we make sure that all fixes are submitted directly to OSM. I just want to give kind of a very quick overview. I get asked a lot, like, how does Daylight differ from OpenStreetMap.org or just taking, you know, a PBF off of the website. So this is just kind of a notional representation of the OSM history. We've got nodes here, ways, and over time, people are making these change sets, and you have these different versions at kind of any given time. Say they're like the minutely diffs coming in, or you just update every day. You can imagine at time t0, you know, you just take a data cut, you get the latest version of every single feature that's on the map. So, you know, version 3 for the first node, version 1 for the second. You can imagine if you take that time cut, you start looking at the planet, you say, what's wrong here? Let's just say on the second node on here, on version 1, you know, maybe there's a problem, the name is wrong, it's a drag node, there's some weird mistake. So you submit a fix, and you have now version 2, and you take a new time cut at time t1. And, you know, what's great is you now have your fix in there. The real problem and things that can happen is that there's a whole host of other changes that have now made it in since then. You know, all these ways and relations down below have changed too. And so what happens is if there are any new issues on those elements, now that you've taken them, you have a whole new set of issues. You have to fix those, and you kind of end up in this kind of loop where, you know, you're fixing things, you submit a fix to OSM, you find it, you take a new data cut, and now you have a whole host of other issues. Daylight is essentially our solution to that problem. Daylight essentially gets rid of the notion of taking a single time cut. And what we can do is sort of cherry pick the best version of all the nodes, ways, and relations, and minimize the total number of issues that you might care about over the entire planet. And when I use the word safely here, what I mean is things like referential integrity. You're not going to have a way that is referencing nodes that no longer exist. And we're not going to end up with things in weird states where, you know, the road network is broken because we weren't really careful about which versions of things were essentially plucking or cherry picking. I just want to talk about a few of the important things that we look at and make sure that at the end of the day, the Daylight Map Distribution does not contain. So things like name vandalism. We've actually spent a lot of time leveraging a custom vandalism and profanity model that detects bad names. Probably a lot of people are familiar with New York City being renamed to Jewtropolis. Here's just a couple of other random examples here of like vandalism on an alley name, people changing the name of the lake. You know, as we talk about cherry picking or plucking out the right versions, we make sure none of this is true on essentially every name tag across the entire planet. Another one, this is my favorite thing to talk about because I think it's one of the most underrated but very common issues in OpenStreetMap data, is things like multi-polygon relations that are broken. So if you have something like an unclosed polygon ring or self-intersection, a lot of things cannot build a valid polygon in your data set. And you might build a planet and find there's large lakes, large rivers that are essentially just not able to build, and they're just land on your map. And, you know, for us as Facebook serving that to a global audience, you know, if people see that, they're just going to really lose a lot of trust in the type of data that we're, you know, serving to everybody. So we make sure essentially all of these and a variety of other things, I also listed out coastlines here, are clean and valid across the entire planet. Essentially, that's all I have here in the 5 minutes. I really wish I could talk a lot more about this, but, you know, just to summarize, Daylight Map essentially is cherry picking these different versions of nodes, ways, and relations to minimize some number of issues that we consider to be safe to serve to a large number of users. And the key thing here is it's totally public. We have a website, daylightmap.org. You can just go and download this Planet PBF. We release it to S3 essentially every 4 weeks. There's a variety of other data products on there. There's some really interesting things with like conflated buildings derived from satellite imagery. So we find buildings in the satellite imagery that are not in OpenStreetMap and offer that as an OSC file that you can essentially just apply over that exact planet. We also apply things like, or supply things like coastline, land, and water polygons built for each daylight map. And you know, I really just want to reiterate, it is 100% OpenStreetMap data. Every single thing in the PBF has an entry in the OpenStreetMap history. You know, it's not 100% of OSM because we only consider a subset of the things generally that we found are important to a lot of users, but it is 100% OSM. And, you know, again, the data is not from a single time cut. One last thing, you know, I want to say the main takeaway is that the number of flagged issues, the number of things that you might detect, issues, errors, whatever, linters, whatever you want to call them, the number of those in a daylight release is typically far lower than any single time cut you can take from osm.org. And that's really what I think the main value of that is. And you know, we offer that for people to serve to their users. If you're looking for a safe and clean validated data set, it is literally the same thing that we push out to Facebook production map surfaces. So with that, if you have any feedback or if you want to participate, if there's something here that, you know, some checks that you think are really important that maybe we're not considering, we would love to work with you and love to hear any feedback you have. We have a Slack channel here for the OSM US Slack group. You can email osm@fb.com. And of course, I have to mention, we are hiring. So if you're a software engineer and you love working with OpenStreetMap or maps data or geospatial databases, anything like that, definitely reach out. Here's my email. It's jwasserman@fb.com. And with that, I will yield the floor. Thank you very much.